Welcome to this YouTube channel Learn Quick. I am Sharif, here to explain you a problem on development of solids cone. Before we start to draw the problem, so we will discretize the question into three parts so that we will understand the question better. So a cone of base diameter 40 mm and height 55 mm is resting on its base on HP. So to design the default position of this cone, so we will refer our previous video lecture projection of solids position number 3, which lies in 6th minute of the video. So to watch the video, kindly click on the link which is available in top right corner or in the description of this video. So the second part is, it is cut by a sectional plane perpendicular to VP inclined at 35 degree to HP bisecting the axis. So we are going to cut the cone keeping the cutting plane perpendicular to VP and at an angle of 35 degree. And this cutting plane is going to bisect the axis of the cone. So this is the second part of the problem. So in the final part, the third part, what we are going to do in this problem? So we are going to draw the development of truncated portion of the cone. Okay. So we are going to cut and make the cone truncated and then we are going to unfold it. Okay. So and then we are going to see the lateral surface of the cone. So let's see how to do the development of solids cone. The front view and top view of the vertical cone is drawn. So now we will dimension the cone. So we'll dimension for height. And then for diameter of the circle. So you can use the engineering template to draw the arrowheads for dimension. So the height of the cone is 55 mm and the diameter of the cone is 40. Okay. So now we will name the arbitrary points in the base circle. So we will start with the left. So we have divided this circle into 8 parts to create the arbitrary points. We will start with the left and this point is going to be A, B, C, D, E, F, G and H, and your apex is going to be O. So now we will carry over all the arbitrary points to the front view. So this point is A dash, B dash. So behind B I have A, which is not visible, just hidden in my front view. So B dash bracket H dash, C dash bracket G dash, D dash bracket F dash, and then E dash. So my vertex is going to be O dash. Okay. So next we are going to draw the cutting plane. So the cutting plane passing through the axis, bisecting the axis. So the height of the axis is 55. So the midpoint is going to be 27.5. So I mark at 27.5 and I keep the angle of 35 degree to the cutting plane. Keep an angle of 35 degree to cutting plane. So instead of having the cutting plane in this manner, I'm preferring to keep the cutting plane in this manner. So I will change. So I will tell you the reason. So I prefer to have the cutting plane in this direction. Okay. So to draw the cutting plane, so I have to use my HB type pencil. So from your left extreme generator to the right extreme generator, draw the cutting plane. So now after removing the portion, so whatever is remaining in the base, so I have to make it with the HB pencil. So this generator is remaining HB. Similarly, this generator is remaining from here to here.
HB, and then the base circle. Okay, so I should not make this generator and this generator in HB pencil because they are just arbitrary. So now I am going to name the cutting points. So first I have to see the slant slant edge or the generator OA. So it has been cut here, so I have to mark it as 1 dash. So next I have to check OB. O dash, B dash, it has been cut here, it is 2 dash. So similarly OC, 3 dash, for OD, 4 dash, for OE, 5 dash. So and then for OF, it is bracket 6 dash, for OG, it is bracket 7 dash, for OH, it is bracket 8 dash, because they are not visible, they are hidden. Now if the problem is section of solid, then you have to bring all the cutting points to the top view and then you have to show the sectional top view. But this problem is development of solids. So this is not mandatory to do the to show the sectional top view. But if it is in the it is asked in the question, then we have to do that. Otherwise we will directly go to the development. Okay, so to draw the development, first point I have to see for the true slant length. Okay, so in this problem, so the true slant is O dash E dash, or I can consider O dash A dash. Okay, so to make sure, you can see here OE is horizontal. OE is horizontal and it is parallel to my XY line. Similarly OA is parallel to my XY line. Okay, so whatever line is parallel to my XY line, so that line can be considered as the true slant length. Okay, so all the other slant length are not true slant length. So I have to measure O dash E dash. So if I measure O dash E dash, so I got 59. Okay, so here I am going to use the radial line method to develop this cone. Radial line method. Okay, so the true slant length, true slant length of the cone, okay, so it is O dash E dash, so it is nothing but 59 mm. Okay, so next I have to see the radius of the cone. Okay, so the radius of the cone OE is 20 mm. Okay, so now the angle subtended, the angle subtended by the cone is given by a formula theta into radius of the circle, that is OE by O dash E dash. So this is the radius of circle by true slant length. True slant length of cone. Okay, so which is nothing but 20 by 59 into 360. Okay, so if I take my calculator and calculate this, 20 by 59 into 360, I got 122 degree. Okay, so again if I divide this 122 degree into 8 parts, so I get 15.25 degree each. Okay, so I am going to develop this cone making a sector. Okay, the angle subtended by the slant length is going to be 122 degree and each division, each arbitrary point is going to be 15 degree. Okay, so before I start to make the development of the cone, so to make it look neat, so I have to subtract the obtained angle 122 from 180. Okay, so it's a simple math. So if I subtract 180 by 122, so I get 58. Okay, so divide this into 2, so I get 29 degree. Okay, so remember this angle 29 degree. So what we will do here is, so we will make a horizontal line. Okay, so we'll make a horizontal line and then mark a point. Okay, so here, so keep your protractor. Okay, so keep your protractor, and whatever angle we got here, you mark it here, 29 degree. So similarly from here, we got 29 degree. Okay, so now the angle between this point and this point is going to be your 122 degree. Okay, so to make the sector uniform, okay, we have followed this method. Okay, so your straight line is 180 degree. If you separate the obtained angle, we got 58 degree, and then we have to evenly distribute it. So 29 degree here and then another 29 degree here. Okay, so now here I have to draw a line. So here I have to draw a line for the true slant length. Okay, the true slant length is 59. So similarly here the true slant length is 59. Okay, so now with help of your compass, make an arc. Okay, since I know in the end this arc is going to be remaining, so I made it in HB pencil. So now I divide this arc into 8 equal parts. So first this sector, which is of 122 degree, I will make it into 61. I will make it into half. I will make this into half, and then I will divide this circle, divide this sector into half, and then again I will divide this into two equal parts. So 30.5. So again I am going to subdivide it into 2, 15.25. Okay, so now we will name the points in the development. So this is my capital O, and this point is capital A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, and then again A. Okay, so now we have to carry over all the cutting points from the sectional front view to the development. Okay, so before doing that, we have to bring all the cutting points to the true slant length. So you keep your drafter horizontal and then bring all the cutting points to the true slant length. Okay, so now in true slant length we will mark this as 1, 1 dash, and then (2, 1 dash, 8, 1 dash) 3, 1 dash, (7, 1 dash) 4, 1 dash, (6, 1 dash) and this one is 5, 1 dash. Okay, so now what we will do is we will use our compass to measure the first cutting point O dash to 1 dash. Okay, measure from O dash to 1 dash and then mark in the respective generator. Okay, so this is my 1. Okay, so next measure O dash to 2 dash as well as 8 dash. So 2 dash belongs to B and 8 belongs to H. So you mark 2 and then 8. So next measure O dash to 3 dash as well as 7 dash. So mark from O to C 3 and O to G which is 7. Okay, so this is 3, this one is 7. So next measure O dash to 4 and 6. So from O in generator D is your 4 and cutting point 6 in F. 4 and 6. So finally measure O dash to 5 dash. So from O mark 5 in generator E. So this is your 5. Okay. So now with the help of HB pencil we are going to draw the lines which are remaining. Okay. So from 1 to A remaining I have made it into HB pencil. So similarly from 1 to A is visible and it is remaining. So make it in HB pencil and I should not make this generator in HB because they are just arbitrary. Okay. So now I have to join 1 to 1 with the help of a French curve or using freehand. Okay. So you can also do dimensioning for this angle subtended by the slant line. So using the engineering template to draw the arrowheads. The angle is 122 degree.
I hope you like the video on drawing the development of truncated portion of the cone. In case if you like the video, press like button, do comment, share and do not forget to subscribe the channel. Thank you.